The Lawrence family. Andrew, Jill, Carol, Christy, and Jack, ready for action. Playing against the Johnson family. Charles, Susan, Dorothy, Charles, and Bob. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Thank you so very much. Hello to the Johnson family. It's the Lawrence family one more time. Thank you so very much. There's enthusiasm permeating this building. Who will be called the champions at the end of this day? Will it be our current champions? Yeah! The Lawrence family, headed by Jack. Jack, tell everybody who you brought with you to be such a winning family.
I brought with me my oldest daughter, Christy.
Hello.
Hi.
My youngest daughter, Carol.
Hi.
Welcome back.
A middle daughter, Jill.
Hi. Nice to see you.
And my son-in-law, Andrew.
Hello, hi, Andrew. Nice to see you back on the show. Will you be able to defeat, all the way from New York City, the Johnson family? Charles, how you doing, my friend?
How you doing, Ray?
I'm doing great. Where is the Johnson family from?
Well, we're from the Big Apple, New York City.
The Big Apple, as I said.
And Hopewell, Virginia.
And Hopewell. Who'd you bring with you?
I have my son, Charles.
Howdy.
My sister, Susan.
Hi, Ray.
Lovely.
My cousin, Bob Pope.
Howdy, Ray. Bobo?
Bob Pope.
Bob Pope.
No, not Bob O.
Okay,
Bob Pope.
Bob Pope.
And my mother, Dorothy.
Welcome to the show.
It
got the feud attitude. Let's play the feud. Come on, Jack. They got the feud attitude. First family to $300 will play for $10,000. Good luck to both. We've got the top six answers on the board to a question that we ask 100 people. Try to find the most popular answer to this thought-provoking question. Name something that a credit card company wants to know about you before it will issue you a credit card. Charles.
Your employment history.
Employment history. Yeah. Occupation. Jack, two answers could be more popular. Something a credit card company wants to know about you before it issues you a credit card.
Your credit history.
Your credit history. Number two. Think of a steal, Charles. The Lawrence family has control right now. Hi, Christy.
Hi.
What would you say? Something a credit card company wants to know before it will issue you a credit card.
How much you make.
Do they want to know how much you earn? Income. 51 people said it. Come on, Bob. Bob Pope, think of a steal. That's a cute name. Carol?
Well, I'm going to say if you own a house. Do you own a house?
They want to know if you own a home. Hope. There you go. Hope for the Pope. Think of it, Bob.
All right, gotcha.
Jill?
They want to know where you live.
Yeah. They want to know where you live. They don't care where you live on our survey. Two strikes. Think of a steal, Johnson's. $80 could be yours, Andrew.
Your savings.
Do credit card companies want to know your savings? Bank references.
Yes.
Three people said that. Jack, keep it rolling, pal. What do you say?
Oh, my.
It's tough. Two answers left.
It's tough. I'll say your income history.
Three seconds. Income history?
History, yeah.
History of your income. Let me see. Okay. Income history. Now, there are no lights. Was that three strikes? Thank goodness I was paying attention, Judge, even though that you didn't notice it, I saw it for you. Dorothy, one answer. You're welcome. Something that a credit card company wants to know about you before it will issue you a credit card.
Your age.
Your age. Bob?
Your marital status.
Marital status. Susan?
Other references.
Other references.
Social Security number.
Social Security number. Charles, you can go with him. It's a tough one. Two answers get you $83. What do you say?
Other references.
I'm going to go out on my own and say other debt.
Other debt. On your own. The family says nothing. They don't say bad. They don't say good.
Good answer.
There, Charles. Very wise choice. Do credit card companies want to know other debt? The Lawrence family keeps the bank. Excuse me. Charles, that was a good answer. It was a good one. Did your family know? Two answers would have stole that bank. Number four. How long at your job? And number six.
Social Security.
Charles, did you say that? We are coming back. You never know what's going to be on the survey after these messages. Hurry back. We are feuding the Lawrence family, $83. The Johnson family, zero. Here we go. With another face-off. Good luck, Charles. Good luck, Christy. Before we do this face-off, just want to take another second to tell everyone, starting Monday on The Feud, all week, Battle of the Centerfolds, Playboy Centerfolds of the 80s against Playboy Centerfolds of the 70s. Charles, is that why you're going like this?
Yeah.
All right. I don't blame you. I'm anticipating it as well. Make a note, but today, two great families, Charles and Christy, representing their families with a question, the top six answers on the board. Name something that has a string or strings attached. Charles.
A yo-yo.
Show me yo-yo. Number one. Yo-yo. Susan. Something that has a string or strings attached.
Instrument. Violin.
All right. Is it a violin? There it is. Now, is it, Susan, I don't mean to pry, but you have a very interesting occupation.
Yes.
What do you do?
I'm a pastor of a congregation, a Baptist church in New York City.
I understand that that is the oldest. Now, what's the history? It's the oldest?
It's the oldest Baptist church in Manhattan.
The oldest Baptist church in Manhattan?
Yes, and I'm also a chaplain for the New York City Police Department.
Yeah!
Yes!
Very
cool. New York City's finest.
New York City's finest. We move down here now to a very interesting man. You are a pastor in a Baptist church, and
This is my cousin.
Your cousin, Bob Pope.
Bob Pope.
He's named Pope. It's quite interesting. Rhymes with Bob Hope, and it has a religious connotation. Something that has string or strings attached. Bob Pope. I love that name. I just got to keep saying.
All right. A clothesline.
He's so into the game, too.
Clothesline.
Strings attached to a clothesline. We're looking for something that has a string or strings attached.
A kite.
Yeah!
All right, good answer.
Show me a kite. Number four. Think of a steal over there. Charles? Charles, you have an interesting occupation. What do you do?
I'm a lawyer for our family business.
Okay, were you in politics?
I was in politics. I was in the New York State Legislature. I was the youngest legislator representing the Yankee Stadium area. Yeah.
Unbelievable!
The Bronx.
The families we have on the show, think of what you've done, Jack. I'm coming over there in a minute. Charles, something that has a string or strings attached.
A guitar.
Show me a guitar! Bam! Number two. Come on, Charles. Something that has a string or strings attached.
A business deal.
Huh? Boy, how old are you, Charles? How old are you?
15.
15 years old. He's 15. 15 years old. Do you love me, baby? I love you. There ain't no strings attached. All right. Show me a business deal. No. Good answer, Charles. Susan, keep it rolling.
A bass.
A bass?
A bass.
How about boom, 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 boom. A bass. No, Lawrence family. You'll take $58 if they name something that has a string or strings attached. Andrew?
A balloon.
Balloon?
A bunch of balloons.
Bunch of balloons?
A balloon.
Bunch
a
of
relationship.
Relationship. Jack, with them or out on your own?
A bunch of balloons.
I am happy to say a bunch of balloons.
Yes!
$58 more dollars will come this way if we see a bunch of balloons. One of the two got that back. Here's one answer would have kept you rolling, Johnson's. Number five. Puppet or marionette? You don't have to be a puppet to come back after these messages. Come back on your own accord. See you in a moment. We have got a feud. The Lawrence family, $141 to Johnson, zero. Let's go. Right now with another. Susan against Carol. Top five answers are on the board. Listen carefully and tell me someone named Peter from a children's story or rhyme.
Peter and the Wolf.
She said Peter and the Wolf. Not fair. Any answer gives you control, Susan. Someone tell me named Peter from a children's story or rhyme.
Peter Pan.
Let me see. Peter Pan is number one. Here come the Johnsons. Bob, come on, Bob. Let's go, Bob. Someone named Peter from a children's story or rhyme.
Peter Rabbit?
Let me see. Peter Rabbit. Yeah. Come on, Dorothy. Somebody named Peter.
Peter Cottontail.
Yeah. Here comes Peter Cottontail hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity number five. Charles. Somebody named Peter from a children's story or rhyme.
Peter, Peter, pumpkin eater.
This family knows their Peters. Let me see. Peter, Peter, pumpkin eater. Number two. One answer. And it's a clean sweep. Charles, 15 years old. Tell me someone named Peter from a children's story or rhyme. Take a guess. 3 seconds.
Peter Wolf.
Okay. What did he do? Just so that I know.
He lived his life as a wolf.
He lived his life. Peter Wolf lived his life as a wolf. Is it up there? It's not up there. Let me see. Peter Wolf. Lighten up, crowd. It was only one strike, Charles. Susan, you can bring this home. Can famous, you... someone named Peter from a children's story or rhyme. 3 seconds.
Peter Leader.
She said Peter Leader.
You remember him, don't you?
I hope my face is getting red. Let me see here. Peter Leader. Okay, hold on. Let me just get my composure. Let me walk back into this for the clean edit. All right. Bob, they're going to try to steal unless you can tell me someone named Peter from a children's story or rhyme.
Peter the Great.
All right. Let me see. You're still alive on a clean sweep if we see Peter the Great. All right, Lawrence family, if you can't tell me number four, they're going to take the bank. Someone named Peter from a children's story or rhyme, Andrew?
Peter Peterson.
Peter Peterson.
Peter Peterson.
Peter Peterson?
No.
Peter, no.
Peter Peterson.
Peter Peterson? Peter, no. What do you want to say, Jack? Got one answer. I need an answer.
Peter Peterson.
Right now. 3 seconds, Jack. What do you say?
Peter Peterson.
Peter Peterson. Now, who is that? Do we know who that is?
I don't know.
We don't know. If it's not there, the Johnsons have $88. Is it Peter Peterson? What could possibly be someone named Peter from a children's story or rhyme? How about number four? Peter Piper. How about that? $141 for the Lawrence family. Here we go, Johnsons, 88. Let's go with another face-off. We double the dollar value. The top four answers are on the board. We didn't know enough about people named Peter. Do we know enough about this? Name something that parents 20 years ago didn't have to worry about, but now is a serious problem among America's youth. Bob?
Drugs.
He said drugs. Number one.
Okay, hey.
Good job, Bob. Really fine job. Think of a steal over there, because you didn't know Peter Piper. Dorothy?
Drinking.
Show me drinking. Not there. Good answer, Dorothy. Just didn't make the survey. Parents 20 years ago didn't have to worry about it, but today it's a serious problem with America's youth.
Homelessness.
Is it? Homelessness? Two fine answers, not on the survey. Now listen to me, Charles. Name something that parents 20 years ago didn't have to worry about, but now is a serious problem among America's youth.
Killings of children.
Would it be, killings? It's not there. Now, it might not be that easy to steal, but you can take a real big lead. Something parents 20 years ago didn't have to worry about, now a serious problem among America's youth.
Kidnapping.
Kidnapping?
Gang.
Gang. Gang. Gang. Gang. Sex. Gang. Now, Jack, you can go with him or out on your own.
Gangs are sex.
Gangs.
3 seconds, Jack.
Gangs or games?
Gangs.
It's gangs. If it's not there, the Johnson family have a big lead. Is it gangs? The Johnsons take that back. Could be a lot bigger. There are three answers, and we should all pay attention here. Something parents 20 years ago didn't worry about, now a serious problem among America's youth. Number two. AIDS. Number three, pregnancy. And number four, violence in school. It's time for another face-off right now. Let's go as we triple the dollar value. Good luck, Dorothy. The dollar value is tripled. The top four answers on the board. We ask 100 people. Name something that's supposed to bring you good luck. Andrew?
Four-leaf clover.
Show me four-leaf clover. Number one, think of a steel, Dorothy. It's real important. Jack, something supposed to bring you good luck.
A kiss from your wife.
How about a kiss from your wife? Johnson, think of a steel. You can win. Christy?
A rabbit's foot.
Rabbit's foot. Number two. Okay, what do you say, Carol?
I'm kissing the Pope's ring.
Start kissing it, Bob. Let me see. Kissing the Pope's ring. You can win the game if you steal Johnson's. Jill, keep it rolling.
A lucky penny.
Maybe a lucky penny? Yes. One answer. You're playing for $10,000, Andrew. What would it be? Something that's supposed to bring you good luck?
Kissing the Blarney Stone.
Kissing the Varney, the Varney Stone? Kissing the Varney Stone. One answer will win you the game. Help Charles, Dorothy. Something that's supposed to bring you good luck? What do you say?
Kissing under the mistletoe.
Kissing under the mistletoe. When, Bob?
A horseshoe.
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 Lucky coin.
Lucky coin, Charles?
Lucky coin.
What, Charles, what do you say? You horseshoe. Seem to light up.
We're going to go with horseshoe.
That's a fine, fine answer. Lawrence's, if it's there, they're the new champions. Show me horseshoe. $1,300. You played so well. Gosh, they took it to you. God bless you. Stay right here. Andrew, fine job. I need two players right now for $10,000. Who's playing first? Let's go. Call it. You can come with me first, Charles. All right, you're off stage. Come on, Susan. Fast money right after this for $10,000. Name something that's supposed to bring you good luck. Andrew?
Four-leaf clover.
Show me four-leaf clover. Number one, think of a steel, Dorothy. It's real important. Jack, something's supposed to bring you good luck.
A kiss from your wife.
How about a kiss from your wife? Johnson, think of a steel. You can win. Christy?
A rabbit's foot.
Rabbit's foot. Number two. Okay, what do you say, Carol?
I'm kissing the Pope's ring.
Start kissing it, Bob. Let me see. Kissing the Pope's ring. You can win the game if you steal Johnson's. Jill, keep it rolling.
A lucky penny.
Maybe a lucky penny? Yes. One answer. You're playing for $10,000, Andrew. What would it be? Something that's supposed to bring you good luck?
Kissing the Blarney Stone.
Kissing the Varney Stone? Kissing the Varney Stone. One answer will win you the game. Help Charles, Dorothy. Something that's supposed to bring you good luck? What do you say?
Kissing under the mistletoe.
Kissing under the mistletoe. When, Bob?
A horseshoe.
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 Lucky coin.
Lucky coin, Charles?
Lucky coin.
What, Charles, what do you say? You horseshoe. Seem to horseshoe. Light up.
We're going to go with horseshoe.
That's a fine, fine answer. Lawrence's, if it's there, they're the new champions. Show me horseshoe. $1,300. You played so well. Gosh, they took it to you. God bless you. Stay right here. Andrew, fine job. I need two players right now for $10,000. Who's playing first? Let's go. Call it. You can come with me first, Charles. All right, you're off stage. Come on, Susan. Fast money right after this for $10,000. Here we go for $10,000. We put 15 seconds on the clock. Wish the Johnson family much luck. Headed by Susan, we ask 100 people these five questions. Name a specific household job that your kids avoid like the plague.
Clean the bathroom.
A U.S. city, often in the news.
New York.
The most profitable game for gambling casinos.
Blackjack.
A jewel that is also a color.
Ruby.
How many hours is a long movie?
Two.
Turn around, let's see what you did here, Susan. Stay right here with me, stay close. Specific household job your kids avoid like the plague, you said? Cleaning the bathroom. What did the survey say? Eight. You're on the board. A U.S. city, often in the news, you said? Yeah. New York. And the survey said? Start spreading the news. 37. Most profitable game for gambling casinos, you thought? Blackjack. The survey said? You got blackjack. 44. A jewel that is also a color, you thought? Ruby. What did the survey say? Bam! 15. How many hours is a long movie, you said? 2 hours, and the survey said 3. There you go. Very, very good. Cover those answers. Here comes the brother Trout. 58 points. All you need for $10,000. You look straight ahead. They put 20 seconds on the clock. Step you over just this way a little bit, Charles. Good luck. We ask 100 people. Charles, you scooted all the way back. Don't do it again. Here we go. Name a specific household job that your kids avoid like the plague.
Washing dishes.
A U.S. city often in the news.
New York.
Try again.
Washington.
The most profitable game for gambling casinos.
Blackjack.
Try again.
Slot machine.
A jewel that is also a color.
Ruby.
Try again.
Pass.
How many hours is a long movie?
3 hours.
A jewel that's also a color. Okay, that's 4 of the 5. Turn around here. Charles, you gave good answers. Come here. You got 4 of the 5, 58 points away. You gave some very good answers that were duplicated. A specific household job that your kids avoid like the plague. You said washing the dishes. What did our survey say? Bam! 26. Cleaning or picking up the room was number one. A U.S. city often in the news, you said. Washington, D.C. What did the survey say? 30. Excellent. Number one was Washington. You're 2 points away from $10,000. The most profitable game for the gambling casinos, you said? Slot machine. Did 2 people say it? For 3 cherries, what did the survey say? Yeah! The Johnson family. Blackjack, number one. Ruby and Jewel, it's also a color. 3 hours for a long movie. Hurry back. The Johnsons are the new champions.
I'm Olympic volleyball player Carrie Walsh. Watch me on an all-new season of Extreme Dodgeball on GSN. The impact is back.
Extreme Dodgeball. New season, new captains. Tuesday nights at 10 on GSN.